So, this fate cannot be the object of ideation. Fate is simply the reaction of original action. So, when there is no original action, there cannot be any reaction. So, reaction is a creation of your own action. When reaction is a creation of your own action, you are the creator, you are the father of reaction. So, how reaction can be your object of ideation? No. A man must not be fatalist. A man must not be fate worshipper. A man should be bold. He should boldly face all troubles, all consequences. He must not be fatalist. So fate cannot be the object of meditation. Fight against fate. Then, some people say that this earth is of accidental creation. This universe is of accidental creation. And accident is the root cause of this creation. So, accident is the God because it created the world. And so, accident should be the object of ideation. It is also a foolish idea. What is accident? There is nothing called accident. Everything is incident. When an action is materialized within the short span, within a very short span, or when the root cause of the action is not known to us, we are just seeing the reaction, we are just seeing the incident, the causal side of the incident is not known to us, or when the causal side is translated into action within a very short span, we say it is accident. But actually nothing is accident, everything is incident. Because of our futility or because of our want of knowledge, we say it is accident. When the causal side, when the causal factor is translated into action within a very short span, say within a few seconds, we say it is accident. And when it is translated into action slowly, we do not say it is accident, we say it is an incident. So, accident is not something providential, or accident is not something beyond the scope of time, space and person, because all accidents take place within the span of the scope of time, space and person. The entity that is within the, not beyond the periphery of time, space and person, cannot be your goal, cannot be your object of ideation, cannot be your object of meditation, and cannot be your creator or the source of exaltation. Some people say, these quilt mental factors, suppose this universe is made of the quinquilt mental factors, what are these factors? They are nothing but condensed form of energy. And what is energy? It is nothing but the condensed form of psychic stamina. Then how these quinquilt mental factors of this express world can be the object of ideation? They cannot be your goal. They cannot goad you unto the path of beatitude. So those who are worshippers or meditators of quinquilt mental factors are misguided people. They are just wasting their energy for nothing. Some people are of opinion that the cosmic energy is the original source or causal matrix of the universe. Hence, this causal matrix will be the object of ideation. But what is this causal matrix? Causal matrix, this cosmic energy cannot be regarded as the causal matrix because it is a blind force. Energy is a blind force. Electricity is a blind force. It is being controlled by human intellect. So, the cosmic energy, having no intellectual support behind it, cannot be the causal matrix, because everywhere in this universe we see everything is in an orderly style. That is, there is something intellectual behind the cosmic energy, and that's why there is order everywhere. There is system everywhere. The entire creation is of a systematic order, so it cannot be a creation of blind force or blind energy. There must be some intellectual force behind it. So the cosmic energy cannot be treated as the causal matrix and cannot be ascribed. No godhood can be ascribed to it. It cannot get the status of causal matrix.